Every business owner needs three things to succeed in this world. Number one is the constant lead generation system. This is a system that enables them to constantly get in contact with people that would one day buy their product. Number two is the qualifying system. The system that will enable them to prepare their prospects who have indicated interest and preparing them with proper education and nurturing system to get them ready to buy their time selling different kind of products across the world. This includes selling physical products, digital products, and offering my services across the world. But I've consistently had this single problem that have been eating me up. This problem. The problem I've faced over the years was having a single place where I can generate these leads, nurture them and close them without having to use multiple tools, do a lot of things and involve a lot of human resources. And this problem has literally eaten me up so much through the years. I've also launched softwares and digital products across the world, but this problem is consistent. In fact, the last software launch I did currently has over 303,000 users across the world and is currently processing 7 figures every week in transaction. That's how powerful my launches has been. Building solutions have always been part of me, and this time I'm taking it to a whole new level. In 2021, I made the first attempt to launch this solution, but I had to stop. But now is the time. I am happy to announce that we have taken on the journey to building and simplifying lead generation, nurturing and closing for businesses, and that journey has just gotten started. And we are starting this journey by launching Salesoo 1.0. With Salesoo 1.0, which is the first version, you can do the following. You can generate quality leads using our supersonic lead generation infrastructure, which we made it very easy for anybody to create, set up, and deploy almost immediately. And of course, with Salesoo 1.0, you can actually deploy our automation system and infrastructure for your business, where you can connect your leads from the point of joining your list to the point of getting them ready to buy the product. And there are also a lot of in-betweens that we have added to make this experience whole and complete for you and your business. We've made the plans for this software very easy to access for different kind of businesses and the levels they are currently operating on. So we have the basic, we have the pro, and of course the ultimate plan for now, which is called the Sales Owner plan. So for every business, for any level and for any revenue level you are on, there is a plan available and affordable and easy to use for your business. For us, building Salesoo is a journey. So while we continue building Salesoo, we will continuously provide updates, upgrades, and of course, improvements to the software as the day goes on. And in the coming months, we will be releasing, of course, Salesoo 1.5 and Salesoo 2.0, which is the mega launch. However, for now, I'm super excited for this, our progress thus far, and I'm super excited to welcome you to join us in this journey. But of course, without any further ado, welcome to Salesoo, where you can generate, nurture, and close leads with just a click. Welcome.
Hey, welcome to Salesoo. I just want to show you how to set up your Salesoo account. You could decide to create your account using your personal information, or you could use the Google Auth option to create your account. I'm going to use the Google Auth option by just clicking this and then selecting a Google account that I want to use. Once you select your Google account, your Salesoo account will be automatically created for you, and you'll be required to then log in. Once you are done, click on this button and then log in with the same email you used to sign up. And then once you are signed in, The very first thing you have to do, the very first thing you have to do is to set up your business account. In my case, I'm going to use a default one of my business names, and then this is how you go. So the goal of setting up your business account is that it will enable you to manage all of your business information from one dashboard. In the future, we are going to allow you to create multiple business accounts for different businesses that you own or you are currently running. So once you fill in this information and select the country you are also from, you click on the continue button, and then the next part will load up. The next thing you have to do is to integrate your WhatsApp with your dashboard. You have to do this just once and you will not have to do it again. So you scan the QR code on your screen and this QR code will connect you straight to your dashboard. And then the next thing you have to do is to log in into your account. However, if you're having a bit of a difficulty to do this now, you could click on do it later and then complete the step later. But it is important because the majority part of the software, you will need your WhatsApp to do that, because the WhatsApp automation system is one of the powerful features we have in the Salesforce version 1. Okay, so I'm just going to click on do this later and then we are back into our sales dashboard. The first thing you have to do is to choose a plan. Okay, choosing a plan is very simple. And then if you click on choose a plan, there are basically three plans available on sales right now. And of course, as at the time you'll be watching this video, it will definitely not be what you are saying, right? Hopefully it won't, or maybe it will be the exact price. But this is just a demo to walk you through. You can either choose the monthly or annually, and always remember to select the currency appropriate for you. If you're in Nigeria, you can select the Nigerian Naira. If you're in Ghana, you can select any currency you choose. If I select the USD, then I'll have to pay in USD. So let's select the Nigerian Naira. Then I click on subscribe to Basic. And then, of course, this is it. So whatever currency you want to choose, you can. But of course, I love USD and I'm going to pay in USD. And I'm going to select monthly. We can actually pay annually. Click on create payment. Very easy to follow step. Continue. Read the information. If you're going to pay through transfer, this is the account name. And then once you are done, you're going to head straight to making your payment. Then on this screen, you just have to input your card details and click on complete payment. Once you are done with it, the next step for you is to log into your Salesforce account and then do the following. Let me show you how it looks like after you've made your payment. So once you are done with the whole process, connected your account, your WhatsApp business account or your WhatsApp personal account, whichever WhatsApp you're using, but of course you have made your subscription, and this is how your sales dashboard will look like. The very first thing you want to do and the very first features we have available for this version one is on the lead generation page. So you come here, you create a list. A list, of course, is a section. It's just a category to help you organize different people. So let's say, for example, you're a course creator and you have a webinar you want to host. So let's call this affiliate webinar. Okay, create your affiliate webinar, give it a description, which could be this is for my affiliate webinar class. Okay, and then you click on create. It's very important to create a list, of course you know how it works. And of course, for this account I'm using right now to do this test, I've crossed the maximum account limit. I'm encouraged to upgrade. Of course, for each category select, there are limitations to each subscription account to pay for. So we always encourage you to go for the highest package where you have everything 100% unlimited. So, but that's how you create your list. The next one is for you to create your form. We made the form to work seamlessly with our integration system. If I create a form right now, let's call my form the webinar form. Okay, webinar form. And then I could select any type of form. It could be a lead generation form. Lead generation form basically has your full name, your email address, and WhatsApp. But if you want to add more fields in your form, you could basically just select the sales form. Now the sales form allows you to add other fields, and you could call this field, I could basically call this field location. Okay, occupation. Let's call it occupation. And then I click on the save field, and it saves this field for me. So I would have 5 fields. I could add more and add more and add more. But for this case, we'll just use the lead form because we just need these 3. But however, if you don't want to collect their email, you can as well hide their email. If you don't want to collect their number, you hide their number. But of course, we need their WhatsApp number because we want to do our automation and marketing through WhatsApp, which is the beauty of Sales 1.0. Of course, I'm going to save this. Let's save it directly on our AM list that was previously created. And then the CTA title of our form is register, join the webinar. Okay, let's call it join the webinar. Okay, and then I click on create form. Okay, at least one field must be saved. Okay, so we have a field that is not saved. So of course, we did not even tell it. Of course, we have to select redirect recipient. So after they fill the form, where do we want to take them to? You put the URL you want to take them to after registration. So in my case, I've selected this URL to redirect them after registration. It's my webinar form, and this is all it. I click on, of course, you could select the color you want your form to have. So I could select any color I want. And of course, I want it to be black. And then I click on save. So I create my form. Immediately my form is created for me, and this is my form right here. The next thing I want to do is I have to integrate my form to my landing page. At the time of recording this video for the version 1, we've not released the DFI page, which should go active very soon, where you can create your landing pages directly from your sales dashboard. But for the now, you could use any free, or if you have your website, you could use those platforms. But however, I click on embed code. Once you click on embed code, you copy the code and paste it directly on your website where you want this form to show up. And I'm going to show you a basic example. All right, over to my website. In this case, I'm going to create a test lead page, and I'm going to call it Salesio Test, or maybe Salesio Webinar, right? That'll be more appropriate, right? And then once I'm done, I'm using Thrive Architect. I'll click on Thrive Architect to load up the page, and the page loads up. So however, I'm going to pick on previous landing page. So I'm just going to pick from the list of default landing pages here, and then we're just going to spice up the whole process. Okay, so this is my lead page, right? I've been able to just craft out something very basic, and it's time for me to add my sales form. So I'm going to just come down right here and click on content box, and then I'll select custom HTML. Okay, custom HTML. I'll drag inside the content box, and then right here I'll paste my code. Remember the code we copied from our website? We'll copy it right here again. Then we'll come back to this page and paste it right here, and then click on save. Once you save this, you could see that the sales form has appeared. And of course, don't worry, the button is actually there, but the button will load up once someone is on the page. So we are just going to click on save work, right? We don't want to do a lot more stuff. We have, but if you want to be more aesthetic, like of course, if it's an advanced sales page designer, you could add some other functionalities on this page, on this section. You could design it. If you notice, the form comes without a background, so you have the liberty to style your page the way you want. So I'm going to attempt to style it a little bit, then show you how it looks like. Of course, because of the principle of minimalistic approach, I was just able to put a border around it right here. I'm just going to click on save. Now, while that is saving, I'm just going to come back here and publish this page and make it go live. Okay, let's click on publish. It's not publishing. So this can work on any kind of website at all, whether it's on WordPress, whether it's your own custom website, whether it's any website at all, this form works on every platform. So let's click on view page now that we've published it. Let's see how it looks like. Exactly, this is how our landing page looks like. This is the fields, this is the button. So right now we're gonna attempt to fill this form with our information, right? And let's see if Salesio is gonna catch it. We're just going to say Joshua. Of course, we're just putting random email, then a phone number. Then we'll click on join the webinar. That was our CTA, right? Click on join the webinar. And let's see where it takes us. And now Salesio will take up the information and store it for in your dashboard. And this is the redirect page we selected. That's it. So let's go back to our Salesio platform. Yeah, this is the form we copied. But let's go to the list. Let's go to list. And the list we added that form was the AM list. If you notice, the number here is now 1. I click on this, I click on view list. Of course, our information should be right here looking at us. And tada, this is our information right here. Now, this is how the form lead generation system works. Very powerful. Let's go to the automation part, which is beautiful. Now, if you've connected your WhatsApp, the whole of this part would work so amazingly well for you. So we have the autoresponder, we have the WhatsApp broadcast, You have the auto reply. The auto reply is basic. You just type in the title here. Let's call this a title for webinar. Let's say during your webinar, you saw the program and you told them, okay, send me the keyword affiliate marketing. And then you receive a link that you use for your payment. Send the keyword affiliate marketing to XYZ number. And then I can now say, hey, hello. I can use the tag name. This will fetch their WhatsApp name. If I say hello name and includes the square bracket, hello name, this is a link to get your course. And then we'll put our link, right? So they just put a link there, show them how it works. And this is it, right? We just save it. So once someone sends us affiliate marketing, they'll receive this link. So continue, save our auto response. All right, so our auto reply works. It just was like semis front. So whether you are there or not there, once they send you that, it comes in, okay? Now the next part is quite interesting. This is WhatsApp broadcast. So I can decide to send the broadcast to any list. If I click on broadcast, it's instantaneous, just like sending a bulk message to people in a particular list or multiple leads. Let's call this broadcast my webinar broadcast. So let's say after your webinar or after your live class, this is just one case scenario that you can use it. You can use it for different case scenario, and you want to follow up on the people that came in or whatever your customers are. You want to follow up them up and then sell them whatever thing, or nurture them or grow them or whatever you want to achieve. So I'm going to just type hi, and then to use the exact name that they've submitted on the list, I'll click on personalize and add first name. If you want to add their last name, you could add their last name. If you want to add an emoji, click on this icon. Sorry, if you want to upload an image, click on this icon and add an image. So I probably will just add an image right here. It says the icon, I'm uploading it. So it will upload the file. This is the file here. If you notice the appended tag here, right? This is not for you to worry. Just move it down to the page. Just make sure it's part of the message you're sending, but it will not appear like this. It's going to appear like an image, okay? So I've said hi first name, hi last name, how are you, and whatever thing you want to say. So whatever information you want to share with them is fine. You could bolden the text, of course, appear bold. You could you could underline, and of course you could add other things, like you could add a hyperlink if you want to. Then, but the interesting part, of course, also you can even share a live location in the broadcast. I could tell them, okay, for those who are doing events, the venue of this event is in Lagos Landmark Center, whatever that is. Okay, so let's make it random. So Landmark Beach. Okay, we'll add it. And of course, it will be added right here. So when they receive the message, they will receive the live location for that event or for whatever thing you're trying to send them. And they can just use their Google Map and get there without hassle. So with this, select the list we want to send it to. Let's say this list, and then this other list, and then this other list. Send it to everybody. You want to set instantly, or you want to automate it. You could decide whichever one you want. So I want it instantly. I'm going to click on the send button, and the message will go viola. So press on send. It's already queued up for delivery. The next few minutes, it will be delivered. Okay, that's how the WhatsApp broadcast works. Okay, probably if I refresh this page, it should have been delivered. Now let's go to the auto response, right? The response is basically you create sequence of messages that will go to your list immediately they join, they fill the form. So someone fills your form and you want to send them 7 days campaign or 10 days campaign. You want to send them a message every day in the morning or whatever time you choose for the next 7 days or for the next 14 days. You can queue up the messaging here. So your nurturing process is easy and straight up. So craft out your messaging. We'll of course be using a feature that will help you craft out your messaging directly on Celso dashboard without you going outside Celso in version 1.5. So well, the first thing you want to do here is to create the title of your address. Let's say this is skincare training nurturing, whatever thing you are doing. This applies for any case scenario, and you can just give it the description so that you understand what you are doing. Let's call it, this is description. So you just describe whatever that auto response is and select the list that you want this thing to work for. So I'm going to say AM list and I create it. Now once you create it, it's now right here, skincare training, blah 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 blah, whatever that thing is, right? And then the next thing you want to do is to click on view threads. View threads will now allow you to create the messaging inside that particular autoresponder. So I'm going to create the first message. This is going to be the first message, so I'll just call it first message. Okay, all right. And then of course all of those customizations still work. Hi, can put in their first name, and of course it will mention their first name right here. And then I can type, this is a demo. And you can type all of your long messages once type and cue them, arrange them, and say, hey, warm regards, Joshua. And of course, you can add a picture if you want to add a picture. You can add a location if you want to. But I want this thing to go immediately, they join the list, and I want it to delay. I want it to go immediately, they join the list. So once they fill the form, this is the first message that goes out to them, and they will receive the message immediately. Step one. The next one is the second message I want to send. So let's call it the second message. And I want it to send 1 day after the first one sends. So 1 day after the first one sends and 2 hours after they fill the form. So 1 day after they send, after the first one sends, 1 day, 2 hours after the first message goes. And I'm going to say, hey, tada, this is the second message, right? And then I save it. That's all. You queue up your messages. So you could keep going, create the third one, the fourth one, the fifth one, the sixth one, the seventh one, the eighth one, tenth one. As long as you can go, it will allow you to do all of that. So when someone joins your list, you will never care about messaging them directly again. This platform will automatically pick them up and begin to send them these messages at the particular time you already scheduled it. And it will keep going and going and going and going until they buy your product. So if you have a 5 days marketing campaign, in that 5 days, you're able to nurture them enough and then sell them your product. In the next version of Salesforce, we're going to allow you to create a nurturing system here where you can generate those contents directly in your dashboard. And of course, create your products right here and share it with them. And then they can buy and you can manage your funds directly on your dashboard. And then you can do a lot more on Salesforce. This is the version 1.0 of Salesforce. We are sure you like it. A lot of people are already using it right now from the beta testing phase, and they are generating massive leads. And of course, you know, the next version we're going to release very soon, in the next few days, we're going to see a lot more solutions we're going to include for you, your dashboard. Welcome once again, Salesforce. Have a great time using Salesforce. We love you.